She looked at me with eyes that belonged to someone else. Her lips turned greenish and blue. Her foot twitched. As I tried to lift her into a sitting position, she rasped. Her eyes rolled back into her head, and she went limp. The man beside me cleans his fingernails with a toothpick. They're flying Ronald Reagan back to California on CNN. I will buy a rolling pin and a bulldozer. I will buy a fast food franchise. I will buy a first edition of Karl Marx's Capital bound in calfskin. I will buy a particle accelerator. I will buy a motorcycle, a Triumph. I will. I am still, except for the pulsing leg and the fluttering eyelid. In my peripheral vision, I can see the service agents busy at the counter readying to call my flight. I will be home tonight. I will save the Times crossword for the airplane. I will ink Proust into squares as the jet's shadow winks over squared prairie fields. The sun will disappear. My wife and I will lie together on our king-size bed. The mattress will seem too big, like a broad sheet of paper with too little type on it. We may set ourselves like two discrete columns with a wide expanse of linen between us. Our daughter may slip under the covers and divide us with her rule-thin body. We may fold together like overprinted letters surrounded by margins of cool white.